Bonjour tout le monde. Today we are going to learn French preposition. Aujourd'hui nous allons voir les prépositions en français. As we know, prepositions are short, but they are very much essential. So let's see the first example. The first word is, the first preposition we use on. On means sur. So S-U-R, sur is on. So when you say like, the cat is on the table, le chat est sur la table. So sur means on, le chat is the cat. Okay, if the another one is under. Under is sous, S-O-U-S, sous. So if it's like, if you're saying like the cat is under the table, so it's become le chat est sous la table, sous. So on is sous, under is sous, sous, sous. So there is a slight difference in pronunciation. It sound like same, but yes, there is a difference. One is sous, another one is sous. Devant is in front. So if you're saying devant, it's like in front. In front is devant. So if you ask to your friend, t'es où maintenant? Where are you right now? So he can say, I'm in the front of your house. Je suis devant chez toi. Je suis devant chez toi. Devant is front of. Chez toi means your house. Next one is behind. Derrière. Derrière is behind. The supermarket is behind my school. Où est le supermarché? Le supermarché est derrière mon école. Le supermarché est derrière. Derrière means behind. Dans is in or inside. Suppose you ask to your friend, où sont les clés? Je ne les trouve pas. So where are the keys? I cannot find them. It's like, you can say, les clés sont dans ton sac. Regarde, dans ton sac is in your bag. So dans is a preposition. It means in or inside. Les clés sont dans ton sac. Above is en dessous de. The bird is above the tree. L'oiseau est en dessous de l'arbre. De l'arbre is, l'arbre is tree. And the preposition is above, that is en dessous de. Next one is below. Below is en dessous de. En dessous is below. And the bird is below the plane. So it's like l'oiseau est en dessous de l'avion. When you talk about between, that is entre. Entre is between. The cat is between the sofa and the lamp. Le chat est entre la canapé et la lampe. Entre is between. In corner of, en coin de. At the corner of the living room, there is a beautiful painting. En coin du salon, il y a une belle peinture. En coin du salon is masculine. So in case of masculine singular, we use du. In case of feminine, we use de la. So it depends on the gender of the noun. Okay, so en coin du means at the corner of. Next one is near. Near is près de. Suppose your friend asks to you, où habites-tu? Where do you live? So you can say, I live near to the post office. J'habite près de la post. So post is post office, près de is a preposition. Près de means near to. And if you say like, I live far from the cinema, so it's like j'habite loin du cinéma. Cinéma is masculine singular noun, that in that case we use du. So de become du in case of masculine singular. J'habite loin du cinéma. Loin de is far away. Where is the post office? Où est la poste? So that is la poste est à côté du supermarché. À côté du supermarché is masculine, so it becomes du. À côté du. So near at the side of is à côté de, and the change according to the gender of the noun. On the left of is à gauche de. The post office is on the left of the supermarket. La poste est à gauche du supermarché. So la poste est à gauche de supermarché. À gauche means on the left of. And on the right of this, the post office in the the post office is to the right of the supermarket become la post a est à droite du supermarché. So à droite means on the right of. Okay, so à gauche est à droite. So la post est à droite du supermarché. The post office is to the right of the supermarket. And when we talk about in the center of or in the middle of, the preposition is au milieu de. Au milieu de. Au milieu du salon, il y a une table ronde. So in the middle of the living room, there is a round table. Living room is salon, that is masculine, so it becomes du. So in front of salon, we put du. Au milieu du salon. Okay, so let's do some exercise. The first one is écrit le contraire. So le contraire is opposite. So write the opposite. Let's see first one. The first one is la voiture est devant la maison. Devant means in front of. Okay, so in front of the car is in the front of the house. Devant, devant is a preposition. So what is the opposite of devant? That is derrière. Derrière means behind. This becomes la voiture est derrière la maison. The car is behind the house. Second one, les livres sont sous la table. Sous means under. The books are under the table. Sous means under. So what's the opposite of sous? That is sous. S-U-R, sous. So it's become les livres sont sous la table, on the table. So on is sur, that is S-U-R, and under is sous. Okay, so sous and sous. U sound comes sous, and that is sous. Third one is l'école est à gauche de la piscine. À gauche de means, yes, à gauche is right or left. Right is à droite, left is à gauche. So this is l'école est à gauche de la piscine. À gauche, the opposite of à gauche de is à droite de. So it's become l'école est à droite de la piscine. Let's talk about fifth one. J'habite. J'habite means I live where? Près de l'école. I live near to the school. The opposite of this sentence, the opposite of près de become loin de. So it's become j'habite loin de l'école. J'habite loin de l'école means I live far away from the school. Six is il y a un sens sous l'arbre. Sous means on, and the opposite of like this one, sous. Sous is under. So it's become il y a un sens sous l'arbre, under the tree. So there is a monkey under the tree. The seventh one is la professeur est devant le tableau. The professeur is in the front of the blackboard. Tableau is blackboard. So devant, the opposite of devant is? Yes, the opposite of devant is derrière. Derrière means behind. It will become la professeur est derrière le tableau. So here we have to write contraire. Contraire means opposite. So devant, derrière, sous, à gauche de, à droite de. Okay, and this one is près de is nearby. La poste est près de la banque, banque is bank. The post office is near to the bank. So what is the opposite of près de? Yes, that is loin de. So it's become la poste est loin de la banque. So loin de la banque is far away. Okay, so this is the exercise. It's based on preposition. Here you have to write le contraire. Contraire means opposite. Okay, so let's see another exercise. Another exercise is based on picture. Okay, so let's see this one. See the photo and tell the correct answer, the correct preposition. The first one is this one. La chat est la table. So where is the cat? Où est la chat? So, regarde la photo et répondez les questions. So the cat is under the table. So under is sous. S-O-U-S, right? So Sue is under, here you can see in the photo, Sue. The cat is under the table. La chat est sous la table. This becomes Sue, sous la table. The cat is under the table. The second one is la table est de l'armoire. L'armoire is Almira. So where is the table? The table is in the front of the Almira. So that is Devo. Devo means in the front of Devo. Okay, so here we put the preposition Devo. Let's talk about third one. La table, il y a des livres et une boîte. Livre means books and boîte is box. So where is the books and books and box? On the table. So it's like sur, S-U-R. Sur la table. So sur la table, on the table, there are books and a box. Une boîte is a box. Fourth one is la boîte, il y a un avion. Il y a un avion means there is a plane. The meaning of il y a is there is or there are. So just see the photo and tell me where is the plane. The plane is in the box, right? In the box. So here, the preposition dans comme, D-A-N-S, dans means in. So in the box, dans la boîte. Boîte is box. Boîte is box. So dans la boîte, box, and il y a, there is an avion. Let's talk about fifth one, la ballon. What is la ballon? Ballon is this one, ball. So where is the ball? Où est la ballon? Le ballon est sur, S-U-R, sur la chaise. Chaise means chair. So the preposition is sur. Sur means on. Sur means on. Sur means under. Okay. Last one is la chaise. La chaise is the chair. La chaise est de la table. So where is the chair? It's next to the table. You can see here in the picture, it's next to the table. So in that case, we use the preposition à côté de. À côté de means next to. Okay, so à côté de. So sur, devant, sur, dans, sur, à côté de. This chapter is finished. Bonne journée. Au revoir.